So we were looking at the output. So just this connection was a little bit problem. The output was not proper. So once you do the probe connection here, then one more thing is you can view the voltages as well as current across the circuit. See, this is what you see is a voltage differential marker. This is the current marker. This is power dissipation marker. So you can see here the voltage display. If you click on this, you can see across which resistor or across which capacitor, how much the voltage is available. Similarly, if I click on this circle, which is written I, so you can see the current display. So what is the current you can see across the circuit? Similarly, this is power display. So what is exact power dissipated across the circuit is also available. So like this, you can see the voltage, current, as well as power. Now, once you save the circuit, so you know PSpice, new simulation, do it, then edit window, give the frequency analysis, then either go to PSpice and run, or you can just give directly run. So once you run the circuit, so it will take time so that you can see the simulation window occurring. For example, here, if I show you the simulation window, you will all get it on the desktop. So this is what your narrow band pass filter. So you can see it is 300 Hertz here and you have 3 kilohertz. So we had given, we need the frequency which has to be passed from 300 to 3 kilohertz. Rest all should be rejected. Now this frequency is nothing but the cutoff frequency what you have, that is 1 kilohertz, the center frequency. So this is the narrow band frequency or narrow band pass filter. The output you should be getting is like this. So here also again, you can suppose your simulation window which you have edited, it is not proper. Then you can go here only, edit settings. Then once you go for edit settings, it will come directly there. What will be the editing settings of your analysis? So you can again interchange it here and then you can give OK. Similarly, you can also go for, in the simulation setting, you can change the color and you can keep the marker as well. See here, if you right click and you can see add, trace, zoom in, what is the log axis, you can plus, see this is a marker point. You can keep the marker anywhere and you can check what is the point what you get there. Similarly, simulation also, you can also run here. Then apart from that, you can change the color as I've told you. So click on this line and you will have the color option which will be available, and you can give text also here. Suppose if I give you, this is the frequency response. Frequency response of narrow band pass filter. So you can give the text and you can just place it above this. And you can also again edit this, change the color here. So which color you want. So this is about the bandpass filter. Similarly, you can also find out what is band rejection filter also. So here, if you go to settings, see this x-axis, y-axis range is also, you can change according to your range. Suppose you want from, say, so if you don't want these lines also, you can give none and you will not be able to see the lines also. So this is how it looks. Similarly, if you go for settings of y-axis, you can get only the x-axis line, how it has gone. Similarly, you can take off the y-axis line also. So this is a narrow band frequency response graph. Similarly, you can do for band stop filter as well. So this is the figure of your narrow band pass filter. So you can also check for the narrow band pass filter. So in the manual, we have taken it as MUA741. Even you can take that OPAM also. I have taken it as LM741. If you take MUA741 also, you'll get the same output as what we have got it here. And here it requires three op-amp. The stall values are same. The only thing you have to change here is to stop the frequency. Start frequency 50 hertz, end frequency is 3 kilohertz. So you can check, and the decade value it is given as 10. So this will do it in the next class. Thank you.